सर आई एम ऑडिबल सर। ओके सर।
यस सर।
I welcome all of you to the session 2 of day 5 of this FDP. I am grateful to introduce our session 2 speaker, Dr. Y.D. Chetan sir, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, MIT College of Engineering, Mysore. Sir secured his PhD in Condition Monitoring from VTU Belagavi. Sir has a professional experience of about 10 years. Sir, research areas are condition monitoring, vision system, artificial neural network. Sir has published 22 reputed peer-reviewed journal, and sir has awarded with the best paper award in international conference on emerging trends in manufacturing engineering held in NIT Tiruchi. And also sir served as a reviewer for many journals. With all this, I request Dr. Chetan Y.D. sir to deliver his speech. Chetan sir.
Okay, is it audible now, Guru Pavan?
Yes sir.
Okay, shall I present it now?
Yes sir.
Okay, thank you for your wonderful introduction. Okay. Okay, is the PPT is visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, welcome you all. Okay. So, today I'm going to present a lecture on tool monitoring by vision system. Okay. Next to next next Okay, so today's course coverage, that is introduction to tool monitoring and machine vision system, then defect identification using machine vision system, then dimensional measurement using machine vision system. Okay, what are the objectives behind this particular course is to create awareness among engineers or engineering faculty on the latest development of machine vision system based on metrology and its application in industries. The second objective is to evaluate measurement capabilities of machine vision system. And the third one is to demonstrate the inspection of components using machine vision system. Then fourth objective is to demonstrate the measurement of tool wear in machining process. And the last objective is to demonstrate the measurement of surface texture of machined components. Since the FTP is on online mode, I could not demonstrate these particular components. So I can reveal the results of experiments we have conducted with this particular domain. Okay, let us start with condition monitoring. So condition monitoring is all about use of technology to measure the parameters like heat, vibrations, sound, electrical output, and vision as well. If you can measure it, and you can definitely you can monitor it. Okay, the next one is with the help of sensors, you can measure the parameters like heat, vibrations, sound, electrical outputs, and vision parameters. Okay, to operate equipment with known status or condition, okay, that is about the condition monitoring. And the intention behind condition monitoring is to predict the impending failures on machine tools or machine elements or cutting tools. Okay, then comparing baseline data to measurements that fall out of tolerance. Then eliminate breakdown events. This is all the intention behind going for condition monitoring methods. Okay, let us have the need for tool status monitoring. Our topic is cutting tool status monitoring. So you're all aware that a tool wear is always undesirable. Wear of cutting tool in machining operation is highly undesirable. So it severely degrades the quality of machine surface, and it causes vibrations and undesirable and unpredictable changes in work geometry as well. So as the quality of cutting tool is directly related to the quality of the product, the tool status should be kept under control during machining operations. That can be achieved with the help of this condition monitoring methods. So from the automation point of view, it is therefore necessary that an intelligent sensing system be devised to detect the progress of cutting tool wear during the metal cutting operations, so that we can replace the worn tool at a particular point of time. Then what actually, so we have utilized machine vision system to monitor the cutting tool status. Okay, then what actually the definition of machine vision system? The definition is very simple. That is the automatic extraction of information from the digital images. Once again, I'll repeat, that is the automatic extraction of information from the digital images. That is called a machine vision system. So the machine vision system has got different elements or components like CCD camera, lighting systems, frame grabbers, and computer and software. So that system that is uses these elements, okay, to visually analyze an operation or activity and to control manufacturing equipment. Say for example, you have got, as I said earlier, it has got different elements, that is acquisition of, CCD camera, you are acquiring the images. So for that, the lighting system, camera and lenses are inevitable. Then representation of digital images, okay, by considering different pixels and colors. Then processing of images, then analysis of images. I'll let you know what actually the concept behind processing of images and different images in the coming slides. Okay, then why we have to select the machine vision system, and we should know what actually the trend behind machine vision system. So here the trend is the machine vision system is moving towards faster and compact system that strike the right balance between cost and capability. That is the reason why the people are being considered the machine vision system for condition monitoring. So what are all the flexibility that is going to offer? So the future challenge for developers of machine vision system is in meeting that requirement of high flexibility, the flexibility in terms of materials, process and pattern design. So okay, irrespective of materials, irrespective of process and pattern design, you can have the machine vision system. Okay, then need in industrial automation. So machine vision applications are used for quality control, security, surveillance, environment in medical field as well. But for industrial application, it is limited, as it has got a limited flexibility. So this is what the statistics, international statistics that is retrieved from World Robotics Magazine in 2018 seems bit older, but that the trend remains same even today. So as we can see the trend that the China is dominating. Okay, it is already been installed 6,000 plus units of machine vision system. Okay, when compared to China, the Indian statistics is it did not exceed the 1,000 units of machine vision system. That shows the lack of research and development done on machine vision system. Okay, so there is a lot of scope for implementing machine vision system for mechanical industries. So the thing is, due to lack of research and development done on machine vision system, that leads to a poor statistics. Then we'll have another slide, that is machine vision application where it can be applied. So the inspection of manufactured goods such as semiconductor chips, we can inspect automobile components. In food processing industries, you can check the quality, and pharma industries, you can have the machine vision system. Then, so let us see what actually the capabilities of machine vision system. So the capabilities, so obviously you can gauge or measure the dimensions, and you can read the serial numbers, and you can have the presence of components, presence or absence of components can be determined. Then pattern matching is done with the help of this machine vision system. Then blob analysis or edge detection can be executed on the images to detect the or to measure the components and its dimensions. Then optical character recognition and barcode decoding is also be carried out with the help of machine vision system. Then surface inspection can also be done. Then color inspection is also possible with the machine vision systems. Then the lighting technique or lighting system is very inevitable for machine vision system. Okay, without lighting, you cannot take the good image or good resolution image. Then if you don't get the good resolution image, then it is highly impossible to extract features. And once you don't have the appropriate features, it is difficult to monitor the status of a particular process. So in that particular point, we have to have a wonderful lighting system. So we have got two different lighting systems, that is front lighting and back lighting. So if you want to inspect a shiny or reflective material, then you can have the a back lighting system. Then if you want to do some experimentation by considering the reflection or the very glazy surfaces, then you can go for front lighting system. So in the back lighting system, you can easily get the sharp edges of the component being inspected, or you can easily detect the presence and the absence of holes or gaps or part placements or orientation, or you can measure the object also. See, this is what the wonderful depiction of the light being applied we easily visualize the component being inspected. We have considered a leaf. Okay, so in front lighting, just you are getting the image of the leaf, and with the help of backlighting, that is going to highlight the edges of a particular component being inspected. Okay, so here if you want to measure, or if you want to gauge, or if you want to execute the edge detection algorithm on the part being inspected, we should go for backlighting. Then, so the next thing is the camera and lenses. This is also an important component in machine vision system. Visualize the components of the this machine vision system, that is sensor size, camera, the working distance, field of view, depth of field, and resolution. These are all the important parameters of camera. See here, the field of view is nothing but the area of the object that will be imaged, that is called field of view. Then resolution can be defined as, that is the number of rows and columns of pixels in an image. If you consider an image, it has got number of rows and columns. So you put all together, you can define the resolution of an image. Then minimum and maximum working distances. The distances from object to the lens, the distance from object lens to the object is called the working distance. Then depth of field can be defined as, that is the maximum object depth needed in focus. Okay, that is called the depth of field. Then we must understand one more parameter, that is called focal length of a camera lenses. So usually we measure the focal length in terms of millimeters, but it is not a measure of the actual length of a lens. Okay, so but the calculation of optical distance from the point where light rays converge to form a sharp images of an object, that is to the digital sensor, that is called focal length. So as you can see, the focal length, that is the distance between the lens to the focal point, this is a point where the light rays are converging towards the formation of an image. Okay, this is the field of view and this is the focal point. So this is the working distance. As I said earlier, the working distance is the distance between the object being inspected to the camera lens. Then, so here you have got different images with a different focal length. Okay, the longer the focal length, the narrower the angle of view and the higher the magnification. So the see here, this particular image has got 300 mm focal length, that is quite longer, and it is the narrower the in the angle of view and the higher the magnification. Whereas here, this particular drawing, you could not see a hut here, because the shorter the focal length and the wider the angle of view and the lower the magnification. Okay, there are two types of lenses, that is prime and zoom. Okay, prime lenses have fixed focal length and zoom lenses have variable focal length. You can turn around and you can change the focal length as well. See here, this is what the camera, that is Nikon D90 or DX camera that was used in the experimentation. So here we have highlighted the focal length of the camera, that is the range of the focal length of the camera is between 18 to 55 millimeters. As and when this system demands, you can rotate or you can turn around and you can fix the appropriate focal length so that you can visualize the component very effectively. Next, some misconceptions pertaining to camera and images. So I'm trying to resolve that particular misconceptions. A camera's total number of pixel is not a reliable indication of camera's resolution or quality. Instead, consumers should look at the number of effective pixels a camera has. Some pixels do not capture the image. Okay, some pixels process the image. So the effective pixels are the number of pixels used to capture the image. So irrespective of the image or the camera, you must concentrate on, while selecting the camera, you should ask the effective pixels that are the number of pixels used to capture the image. You must ask for the effective pixels instead of considering the number of pixels. So for example, the camera resolution is 12.3 million effective pixels. So here, image size is 4,288 into 2,848. You multiply these horizontal and vertical rows, horizontal and vertical rows, then we'll be getting the effectively the 12 megapixel camera. Then sensor cleaning has given the autofocusing and lens servo and continuous and white balancing is embedded with the camera. Then he has given the LCD monitor to monitor the object being captured. Then dimensions he has given, the weight and movie mode also he has given. Then let us start with the digital images. So a digital image is defined as two-dimensional function, that is f of x of y. Where x and y are the spatial coordinates and the amplitude of f at any pair of coordinates, that is x and y, is called the gray level of the image at that particular point. So image representation, as I said earlier, the grayscale image is a function of x and y coordinates and is a two-dimensional array of brightness of the values. See, the totally black pixel that is assigned with a zero. Okay, the pure pixel is assigned with the one, and the varying in intensity of the pixel is assigned with the appropriate number. This particular value is called gray value or gray level. Based on this particular technique, one has to extract the image features. See, this is what's the difference between grayscale image and binary image. So in binary image, we have got only two values, either zero or one. The pixel is assigned with 1 or 0, whereas in grayscale image, depending upon the intensity of the image lighting, that will be each pixel is assigned with the different values. So that is the difference between grayscale image and binary image. So in binary image, we are using only two values. The zero is assigned for black pixel and one is assigned for white pixel. Then the processing. So now we are all familiar with the images, camera, focal length and all. Then we must look into the processing of an extracted image. So what are all these steps involved in image processing? You have got three different steps. That is image enhancement, image segmentation, and edge detection. So in image enhancement, we need to execute the operations like scaling, rotation, elimination of noise associated with the images, and morphological operation to be applied to get the good resolution image by eliminating the noise. That is the steps involved in image enhancement. Whereas in image segmentation, we are segregating or differentiating the region of interest with respect to its background. So for example, if I want to take the human picture and he has got a black hair and the background is also of a black color, then the hair of the human body or the head of the human air that is going to merge with the background, then we need to execute the image segmentation operation so that we can differentiate the region of interest, that is human head with the background, black background. Then the next step is edge detection. So as I said earlier, the edge detection is a method where we are highlighting the edges of the component being inspected or measured. Then again, the subdivided an image into its constituent regions or objects, that is again thresholding, edge finding, then binary mathematical morphology, then gray value mathematical morphology. These are all the different steps associated with the image processing. Then what actually the thresholding means? The thresholding is an image processing technique for converting a grayscale or color image to a binary image. So now you are all familiar with the binary image and grayscale image. The grayscale image has got different values that is being assigned to each and every pixel. So interpretation of that grayscale image is very difficult. That's why the people used to prefer binary images, as it has got only black and white pixels, and we can play with the black and white and we can come out with the appropriate and desired features. For that purpose, we have to have thresholding techniques. So if a pixel in the image has an intensity value less than the threshold value, then corresponding pixel in the resultant image is set to black. Okay, so this is called the offsetting method. See here, easily you can understand now. See here, it has got fasteners. That is basically grayscale image. So our interest is to measure the dimensions of washer and bolt. So for that, the background is of a gray color. So we need to assign only black and white. That's why we have applied some threshold value. So after application of threshold, the background is segregated and only the fasteners have been identified and highlighted here. Then, so an analysis is required to come out with the appropriate results. For that, analysis called blob analysis. A blob analysis is a branch of image analysis that allows identifying groups of pixels within a gray scale image. Once these regions are identified, it is possible to carry out different types of analysis. Say, for example, so here, as you can see, this particular drawing, it has got 10 blocks, each block has got one pixel. So you add these blocks, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 10. So the area of this particular object is 10 pixel unit. Okay. So similarly, the steps involved in blob analysis too. In order to carry out the blob analysis, we have to have different types of steps. Different steps, that is, first one is acquire an image with the help of camera, then use enhancement operation on the image to prepare it for blob analysis. Blob is nothing but is a group of pixel. Okay, so make the blobs clearly identifiable, then select the features to calculate, then calculate the features and analyze the results. So feature is nothing but area, compactness, different parameters like perimeters, area. These are all different features that is associated with the image processing. As far as our research is concerned, we have concentrated on only area as the parameter. Then when does a company need a vision system? So here some product requires 100% product inspection with a documented inspection result. Once you have done the inspection, automatically you can extract and retrieve the features extracted, and you can give the appropriate statistics. For that purpose, the company needs a vision system. Then another case, a vision system may be needed for high production product inspection. Then similarly, a serial defect is spotted. The system is not only recognize it, but can stop the conveyor and inform the operator of the defect and its magnitude. Then one more area where you can have the machine vision system is in the condition where you can have the machine vision is the yield factor is particularly important in manufacturing industry that produces large volumes, and as in the compact disc and pharma industries. Then so this is what the experimental setup we have utilized when we were in research, in doctoral program. So the experimental setup for acquisition of an image. So this is the VFlux software that was sponsored by AICT New Delhi and University of Visveshwaraya Technological University. And here you have got some VFlux toolbar and main window, and this is the main window, and this is the VFlux toolbar, and this is the camera. Okay, camera is connected to the computer system. Computer is loaded with the image processing software, and this is what the fasteners that is being inspected with the help of this machine vision system. So the first experiment was conducted at PES Mandya with the help of this machine vision system is segregation of different coins. As you can see, the different coins, that is 1 rupee coin, 2 rupee coin, this is 50 paisa and 25 paisa coin. So we have done the image processing steps, and eventually it has got some labels. Okay, and the corresponding area that is documented, that is automatically generated trend, and the deviation in the trend due to the 25 paisa coin, as it has got a less area, a less pixel area, that is 18 here. So this is the 25 paisa coin. Simultaneously you can look here, so 18th coin, it has got less area, so that we can easily identify the deviation associated with the trends. Similarly, we have executed the second experiment to gauge or to measure the different or segregate the different size of bolts. See here, again, we have executed the image processing steps on this particular digital images. And finally, we have extracted the images. And with the help of this, one can interpret and one can understand that it is possible to measure the dimensions and the dimensions of the fasteners as well. So this is about the inspection process. Then we thought of extending this particular research to condition monitoring of the cutting tools. For that, we have considered the drilling machine. So the intention is to monitor the drill bit, drill wear. Okay. So here you have got the computer with the image and video processing software, and this is the camera we have considered to capture the image. Each and every completion of the hole, then making the hole, you can take the snap and process it, and you can extract the images. See here, we have considered the experimentation. We have considered three different spindle speed. This is not cutting speed. This is spindle speed we have mentioned in the RPM, and we have considered the three different feeds. That is 0.19 millimeter per revolution, 0.285, and 0.095. Then the experimental procedure is very simple. We used to take the images of the fresh drill bit. Okay, we process it. The segmentation is done. Thresholding is set. Then extraction of feature is done. Then interpretation. This is the one segment. Again, once you completion of the making the hole, then that undergoes some wear. Then the capture the worn out drill bit. Again, you process it. Segmentation is done. Thresholding is carried out, and feature extraction is also done. Then you subtract the image features. Then eventually that would provide the drill wear. So just we are subtracting the values of the fresh drill bit with the worn drill bit, and you are getting the drill wear magnitude. So this is what the different drill bit images that is captured through machine vision system. This is the first that is the drill bit, that is the we are applying the region of interest. This is what the region of interest for us. And you could see the wear on the drill bit.
Sir.
Wait for a while. ಓಕೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ನಾನು ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ನೌ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಡ್ರಿಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದಿ ಡ್ರಿಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ರೀಜನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಸಬ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಡ್ರಿಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕುಡ್ ಸಿ ದಿ ವೇರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಕರ್ಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಮಷಿನಿಂಗ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಡ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಡ್ರಿಲ್ ವೇರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ then see you could observe the parameters or features extracted with the help of this particular software. See area he has given, the perimeters, compactness, height, width, different parameters or features that can be extracted through this particular software. But our concern was to extract the wear area. That's why we have considering only area as the features. So this is what the trend we have established in the experimentation. The red color trend that was established with help of the toolmaker microscope. You're all familiar with the toolmaker microscope. And see here, the first segment that shows the sharp edge of the cutting tool. Okay, as and when the wear occurs, then wear progresses. So here the trend can be established. For different types of or different cutting conditions, okay, and that ultimately gives the tool life. Similarly, we have established a trend with the help of image processing, okay. So here we need not to remove any drill bit here, and directly you can take the snap and you can process it and we can extract the images. So I extract the features and eventually you can establish the trend. So one thing is we can easily compare the trend that is established through the toolmaker microscope and the machine vision system, and the trend follows the same. The next one is the same research is extended to the turning process. Here the intention is to monitor the cutting tool status. So we have considered the inconel 718 workpiece that is difficult to cut alloy that is being machined with the help of carbide tip cutting tools. That particular cutting tool being monitored with the help of machine vision system. So this is the camera. The camera is connected to the computer. Computer is loaded with the image processing software. As and when you complete the first run, you take the snap and put it into the software and extract the image. Then again, you carry out the second run, similarly third, and for n number of runs, you can extract the features and we can establish the trends. So this is what the lighting parameters we have considered. That is, walking distance is 50 millimeter we have considered, and illumination intensity of the light is 60 watts, and we have used the VFlex software, and light used is halogen in nature. See here, this is what the tool visualization and monitoring, that is, this is a fresh cutting insert. Then this is the where you can observe in the first run, in the second run. Similarly, for 6 runs we have documented the images. So the same images is loaded to the image processing software, and the processing is done. See here, this is the digital image. The process is to convert the digital image into grayscale image. Okay, then you have the region of interest. Then you are applying the threshold and gray level values, and finally you are getting the wear area. So you can characterize the wear through this this particular machine vision system techniques. So these are all the trends, that is tool wear and machining time trend. You are all well aware of this particular trends. That is, so the first slope indicates the sharp edge wear, and the second indicates the blunt or the round off of cutting tool. Then if that exceeds the limit, then that demands the change in the cutting tool. Similarly, this particular trend was established with the help of tool maker microscope measurements, whereas wear area and perimeters are all the parameters that was extracted with the help of the machine vision software. Similarly, we thought of extending this particular research on extracting the features or to monitor the surface textures as well. So as of now, we have inspected the fasteners and we have segregated the coins. Then we have extended this particular research.
Sorry, participants, for the technical issue. I will just contact the speaker.
Hello.
Hi, yes, sir. You are audible.
Yes, yes.
Sir, please continue. Participant, sorry for the technical issue. Sir, you may please continue. You may share your screen and please you may continue.
I have concluded the session.
Okay. There was a technical issue.
From where? In from which slide?
Sir. Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your valuable knowledge. Now I request participants to share or clear your queries. Sir, hope that there is no queries from the participant side. So okay. thank you sir, thank you for your valuable contribution, and sorry about the technical issue.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Thank you, Group One.
Thank
and
you,
team.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Okay, sir. Dear participants, now we will break for lunch. After lunch break, we will join back at 2:30 for validatory function, test and feedback. I request all the participants to attend the test without fail for certification.